latest recipe I have for you is with tulsi ginger. This is a very traditional blend. Blending tulsi with ginger is good for even making chai or tea without milk. But then I have hibiscus. The mixture is so good quality, and tulsi and ginger flavors are really well blended in this mix. It looks like this. It has bits of ginger and tulsi in it. Hope you can see. Yeah. So this, I have added 1 teaspoon of this mixture in the mortar and pestle, along with jaggery. So jaggery is also very good quality, and you can see how it is. Like, if there's 1 teaspoon of the tea, I've added like 4 teaspoons of jaggery in a mortar and pestle, and you just blend it for some time. It's jaggery starts melting along with the heat that is generated, and it starts becoming cakey. You can see it has started become cakey here, and you collect it and form it in small little balls. And you can add a little bit of ghee as well if you wish. You start making small balls, and you don't need to make too big balls. It is like a little candy that you can have after meals, and it keeps really well in a airtight container. This kind of small little candies will be really good as a mouth freshener also, and of course it gives you a very rich taste that makes you satiated after a meal.